does. And you're just too busy being mean and stupid to ever figure it out.
I keep trying to run, but my legs won't work.
Mom was right. They are important.
Well, I don't know about you, but the Krell boy really hurt my feelings.
Hey!
Go away, Stevie.
It's good you two are friends. He won't mind sharing his wheelchair.
Okay, this is where something good happens, finally. So we're gonna slow down and make it last as long as possible.
The Possible Dream. Finale of scenes. The moment that some call eternal, that some call insane.
Dude, you hit a cripple.
At once. So the story he puts together is that Spath attacked Stevie for his lunch, and I'm like this hero that stepped in to defend him. It was beautiful. Okay, it wasn't funny when Spath started crying. No, wait, it was.
Dad's hair.
Ugh, yeah, I know. It's gross. But hey, if a bunch of birds can make the best out of what they get, and so can I.
Malcolm!
Like Captain to go to special class. I can make it work out, right?
Malcolm!
Not now. Or my family. We're not the greatest family in the world, but we could get better. I mean, it's not impossible.
Malcolm!
What?
Can I get out?
No, stop asking. So basically, I think everything's gonna be okay.
What'd you do?
What?
Don't give me that. What'd you do?
Nothing.
Mom, I'm trying to study.
Well, I'm sure you don't mind if I, took a look in here.
Mom, I'm telling you, we didn't do anything.
Oh, you boys are up to something. I can smell it. If you've broken another window, it is gonna come out of your...
Are you done? You wanna frisk me?
You just consider yourselves lucky. This time.
That was close.
Either she's losing her touch or we're gone.
So you should be proud of yourselves. Did you do the toy thing yet?
Yep.
Spinning?
Uh-huh.
Okay, good. I think I know where she's going. Separate interviews. Listen, when she gets you alone, she's gonna pretend she's on your side. She's not.
Go ahead. It's a name brand. I'm not mad at you. I know you didn't do this. You're a good boy. But I want you to help me find out who did. This is serious. One of your brothers could have burned the house down, and for that, he will be severely punished. But the one who helps me will be a very happy boy, and I want that to be you. Because you've always been the best one. You've always been the best one. You have always been the best one.
Mom, honestly, I don't know who did it.
I don't know.
Don't know.
Well, Well, I guess you boys think you've got your old mom over a barrel, huh? Well, we'll just see about that. If you boys want to play, we can play all night long.
Stolen everything I love!
Francis, I'm just gonna tell her I did it. I know it wasn't me, but anything is better than this!
Oh, God.
Oh, oh that's man. They tried that psychop stuff on Noriega. They said that by the end, he wanted to cut his own ears off.
Malcolm, you cannot crack now. She will own you for the rest of your life. Now listen to me, Malcolm. You have to do exactly what I say.
Nice is good, mean is bad. Don't be mean, cause mean is bad. Nice is better than mean.
Hugs are good, thugs are bad. Don't be a thug, cause thugs are bad. Hugs are better than thugs.
Did you see that? Come on, sing louder!
Nice is good, mean is bad. Don't be mean, cause mean is bad. Nice is better than
mean. Oh, your grandmother and all your friends are just gonna love this at your next birthday party.
You're kidding me. Okay, just hang in there. Give me a minute to think. Damn, she's good.
Did they crack?
Nah, Dewey faked a stomach cramp. Bought him some time.
Good man. Man, if we would have had your mom and Nam, there'd be a McDonald's in Hanoi Square right now.
Dude, there is a McDonald's in Hanoi Square.
We're gathered here today to say goodbye to Jumpy number 8.
Nine.
He was a good... 9? Are you sure 9? Anyway, he was a very good frog, and he led a very full life.
I remember when I stuck him in Mom's sun visor, and she almost hit that lady in the crosswalk. It was hysterical.
Farewell, Jumpy number 9. We know you're going to a better place.
Bye, Jumpy. Dad?
Man, Kevin, I hate this guy. He's only been here for 2 weeks, and he's already the most obnoxious kid in the school. Little help.
Lose your ballie, baby.
Can I please have my ball back, Kevin? Come on, Kevin. De gusto boost non est disputandum.
De coup. You stink. Your name is Stinky.
Whatever. Just give me my ball back.
You want it? Go get it, Stinky.
The only thing Rowena can't ruin. Hey, no cuts.
Two slices, please.
Is there any more pizza?
No, all out. It's American goulash for you.
What is that?
I don't know. All I can identify are little pieces of carrot. And I don't know, I think they're Skittles.
Hey, look at the goulash boy.
Get away from me, Kevin.
Ooh, get away from me, Kevin. He's so sad that he doesn't have pizza, and I do.
I said get away.
Chill, man. I got your back.
What are you looking at, canard butt?
Light? Some shadows?
Kevin, I'm warning you. Get out of my face.
Aw, Malcolm doesn't like me eating close to his face with pizza I have, and he doesn't. Pizza.
Watching hockey's really paid off. I can't believe how good I'm doing.
7. What's not to understand? He just turned 7. I guess you were too busy beating people to notice.
He can't be 7. He's bigger than I am.
He's in 2nd grade. Oh, look at all this blood.
That's not blood. It's pizza sauce. Well, that's blood, but...
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God! What happened?
I want my Teletubby.
A doll? You can't play with dolls if you're 7. Why are you 7?
You beat up a 7-year-old?
I didn't know!
Malcolm, I don't blame you. I put this squarely where it belongs. On me.
Oh, man. This is the most horrible thing I've ever done. Kevin, I'm sorry.
I think you've done quite enough.
This is the worst birthday ever.
Pass the chips, please.
Here you go.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wow, that was a really great move.
My head just went flying.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I told you, boys, these games are too violent. Here, watch something wholesome.
A gigantic nuclear furnace where hydrogen is built.
Give me more chips.
Get your own, doofus.
Shut up, I'm watching. You shut up, I want more chips.
Here.
Thank you, Malcolm. The kids love you. You're great to have around. You've really become one of the family.
I may not have been switched at birth, but I should have been. I love these people.
Barney. He's part of the family. Just like I'm part of the family, right? And since a big part of this family is being such a huge phony and launching secret investigations against each other, I thought I'd join in. Personal computers are great. You can file tax returns, medical records, embarrassing private email. Little security tip, though. Never use your birthday as your password. And hiding things in a fake salt can? That's just silly. I don't know who Melissa is, but she sure wears a lot of lipstick. Anyway, I think I hear you guys pulling up in the driveway. So let's just leave it at this. I quit. Bye.
Who's Melissa? Oh, hi, son. Didn't hear you drive up.
I decided to walk.
So how's the job going?
They were jerks, so I quit.
Well, that's pretty much what work is. Welcome to the club.
Dad?
Yeah?
I'm really sorry.
What? Not quitting? Ah, no big deal. Especially for you. Malcolm, you should set your sights as high as you can. If anyone in this family has a shot of greatness, it's you. Just, do me a favor. Look after your brothers.
Okay, wait. You mean everything you just said, right?
Well, why would I say something I didn't mean?
See, that's what I'm talking about. This family may be rude, loud, and gross, and have no shame whatsoever. Anyway, with them, You know where you stand. And when I have a problem, they're always there.
Oh, my Lord. Sex.
Things didn't work out so bad. I made enough money to get my robotics kit. Or maybe I should do something nice for my family. Take them to dinner, treat them to a movie. Nah, then I couldn't do this.
You better be running! Hey, Stevie, I got your... Oh, my God! Stevie, are you okay?
Can't feel my legs.
That's not funny.
Awesome.
Well, we kind of got lucky.
I was sort of hoping to get caught.
What?
Never been in trouble. Like to see what it's like.
Sometimes you're such a crawl boy.
I guess we are in trouble, after all. Malcolm? Malcolm? Malcolm?
Could somebody please show me some credit cards? Okay, the numbers on them are 3699-7412-6823-9140 and 3424-1804-1835-3668.
He's right.
Okay.
If you add the individual digits on each card, you get 74 and 66.
If you multiply those numbers, you get 4,884.
How do we even know he's right?
Oh, he's right.
4,884 squared is 23,853,456. The square root of 4,884 is 69,885,000. The square root of that is 8,003,597 tenths.
Factor it.
The factors are 222 and 73.
Multiplied by pi.
26 and 261 thousandths.
Cubic.
584 and 214 thousandths.
What's the arctangent?
89 and 9 tenths degrees.
Natural log.
6 and 3,699 tenths.
What's the reciprocal?
17 ten thousandths.
And bank
11,431.
What's the capital of Iceland?
Reykjavik. But that's not math.
You be Clyde.
Think you can cry?
No, I gotta feel it. Ooh. I got an idea.
No! Just follow my lead.
No, Reese. Whatever it is, no.
Well, I guess you boys had some time to think about what you've done.
Yes, sir.
Look, I used to be your age, and I understand how tempting a place like that can be. And I guess you kids really didn't do any major harm, so I've decided to let you off.
No! You idiot! Oh. Open it! It's locked!
Okay, I think I can cry now.
Oh, jeez.
Come on.
What seems to be the trouble here, Officer Carl?
These your boys?
Yes, sir, that they are. Fine boys. Couldn't be prouder of them.
For your information, these are two of the worst kids I have ever encountered in my life. And I work the state fair.
Really? See, that must be fascinating, seeing people from all over, the different cultures.
Hey, I don't want to be a hard case here, but these kids physically attacked me.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Plus, they completely destroyed a $300 pneumatic drill. What's someone's going to pay for it?
Well, this all sounds pretty serious. But don't you worry, Officer Carl. They are going to hear all about it when I get them home. You see, I'm just sorry that they had to put you through all of this. That's not fair. And I fully intend to pay for...
Ah! Oh! Hi, Kevin! Get to the car! Ah! Oh, 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 oh.
Do-be, 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 do-be.
B.
Do, 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 B. Do, do,
ah. All right, class. Recess is over. I know. Malcolm, I think you should say something to your classmates. They stayed inside while you were out playing ball with your friends.
Thanks.
This isn't fair.
Yes, it is. It's absolutely fair.
I'm getting hungry.
We're doing it my way.
They're getting cold.
You want them divided up fairly or not?
You have more than me.
No, I don't. We all have 29 inches of fries so far. I have 2 4-inchers, 5 3-inchers, and 3 2-inchers. You have 5 5-inchers and a 4-incher. They're exactly the same. Dewey! Okay, we're gonna assume this was a 4-incher from the share pile. 117 minus 3 times 29 divided by 3 minus... We each take a 2-inch bite out of this one.
Hold it.
Why am I doing this?
Stop clouding your mind. This is a process.
Dad, it's street hockey, not clown school.
Process. And what? And dump it over. And what?
When am I ever going to use this?
Full range of motion. And point and bump and point and bump and point and bump. And then we glide.
How about my skates? Can I at least try on my skates?
Absolutely not. You need at least 2 more days.
2 days? Uh-huh. I know enough to play a stupid game of street hockey now. That's all I care about.
Malcolm, we go at the speed I say. This is about safety and proper technique.
But it doesn't make any sense.
That's because you're not in the skating state of mind. Now that's it, okay? We're done. Go home. You know what? Thanks to your attitude, we are now a day behind.
Fine! Oh, man.
I win again.
No fair. My goalie doesn't have any legs.
Hey, boys.
Hey, Dad. How'd you do?
Well, you know, blackjack's a complicated game. You have your ups and your downs. So, who wants to buy me a Coke?
It's too bad you had to quit, Dad. That shoe's full of tens.
Huh?
Tens, face cards. Okay, there's 6 decks. They've already played out 18 nines, 14 eights, 12 sevens, but only 2 tens. A king of spades and a queen of diamonds, which leaves, well, you can do them half.
No, but you can. That's all that matters. Oh, my little genius. Now you have taken it easy. Kick back and relax for a little while. No matter what the world has in store for us, you got to bring that bell, get off of us. Reach out for a comfortable chair. Rejoice and throw your arms in the air. Because it's a good life. So why you're tripping? The good life. It's a good life, so why you're tripping? The good vibes slipping away. Yes, a good life, so why you're... Of course, we're terribly sorry about this. You have to believe that this is a momentary lack of judgment on my part. I realize now that
using my son.
Your underage son.
Yep, my underage son. To count cards was wrong. I guess I was just trying to look for an activity that the two of us can enjoy doing together. You know, it's a tough age.
Yeah, and this was really helping my self-esteem. You see, I'm not really good at sports, and this made me feel special.
My son and I cook.
Oh, that's a good thought. We'll have to try that.
In the meantime, you're banned from the casino.
Banned? Oh, no, you don't want to do that. You see, that's just not going to go over so well with my wife.
Believe me, you don't want to see her angry.
No. I'm not banning her, just you.
Okay, look, let's just forget about the $3,000 that I won. Just pretend it never happened. Capiche?
It's very generous of you. You're still banned.
What? Oh, all right then. Just give me my money back.
I'm sorry. What money?
Hey, look, pal. Who said anything about money? Thank you.
Whole week.
Yes, and to be honest, I think there are some definite issues that you and he need to talk about. Malcolm, you want to share this drawing with your mother?
No, that's okay.
I like what you've done with my teeth.
There's some things that Malcolm told me that I think you should hear.
Oh, well, I'd love to hear them.
Go ahead, Malcolm.
Yeah, go ahead.
Everybody wants to help. You're safe here. About the anger thing?
Yeah. Tell me about the anger thing.
When you're angry, you bottle up your feelings, and you freeze me out with silence.
Well, I will, I'll try to be more vocal.
Go on.
Please.
I wish you would spend more time at home, unless I'm at the racetrack.
Well, I guess I'm gonna have to change that, too.
Come on, Malcolm. Tell her about the pressure.
Well, I feel you put a lot of pressure on me, and I can't live up to your expectations.
What pressure?
Maybe not. I don't know.
No. Go back. What were you saying?
Well, you put a lot of pressure on me and stuff.
What do you mean? When do I pressure you?
All the time. If it's not the extra credit reports, it's all the advanced classes you signed me up for. And after that, I have to help Reese and Dewey with their homework.
That's not pressure.
You know, I didn't ask to be born smart.
We just want you to live up to your potential.
That's exactly what I'm talking about.
Oh, no, don't be. I'm the one who should apologize.
No, you guys just want what's best for me, and I know that.
Oh, we do. We love you.
I love you, too. Oh.
Mom? You really pissed me off when he took away my hockey stick because I was hitting Dewey with it. I know you're sorry. I'll go in the attic and take it down later.
Oh my God, that is so true.
Think of how cute he is with your mom. She was like,
you could totally see
like,
what are you like? She wants to be a slut, that's fine, but don't make me lose my lunch.
I'm totally not calling her back until she apologizes. But by being her friend, I enable her assy behavior.
This must be one of those times where it feels like an eternity, but only a few seconds have gone by.
How come Malcolm hasn't said anything for 5 minutes?
Line?
Normally, I would enjoy this schadenfreude, but this is just sad.
Psst. How now, spirit, whither wander you? How now, spirit, whither wander you?
Oh, and I heard. Like, you it's a swear, and it's so loud. I mean, like, swear.
Ew!
Swear.
Who is that kid? Get him out.
king doth keep his revels here tonight. The king doth keep his revels here tonight. So good night unto you all. Give me your hands if we be friends, and Robin shall restore amends.
Hey guys, what you done?
I wish you could stay little forever.
Leather couch? I'm thinking upscale professional?
Well, if they're living here, they haven't managed their money very well.
Families keep moving in and out of that house. I wonder why. Maybe the house is haunted.
She's out there.
Who?
Emily. The demon child. She's everywhere. No matter where I go or what I do, she's there. I'm going crazy.
Aren't you the one who wanted a feud?
Malcolm, you know I don't think things through. How am I supposed to fight her? I can't hit her. I can't do anything to her, and she knows it. I'm completely defenseless.
Reese, she's 4. You're bigger and smarter than... Well, you're bigger.
Malcolm, would you come out here, please? Malcolm, these people would like a word with you.
We've had a report that you've been seen prowling in the neighbors' yards and peeking in their windows.
What?
So you've decided to become a peeping Tom? A peeping Tom?
But I didn't do it. Why would I want to look in anybody's windows? Have you seen the people in this neighborhood?
Peeping isn't about looks, son. It's about the thrill and exhilaration of observing someone without their knowledge.
Another day of crap. Damn catalogs. Idiot foreman. Watch your step. Whatever. No one gave me a chance. So tired. No one gave me a Pancakes, Dad.
Oh, thanks. Hey, who's ready for seconds?
I am.
Are you okay, Grandma? Because I could carry your purse for you, or maybe your whiskey.
I once strangled a border guard with my bare hands.
Just asking. So, I studied about your country in school.
Always with the books. You won't be happy till you get eye cancer.
No, really. I found the folklore very interesting. And the history, the wars, the revolutions. It must have been very hard for you growing up.
It was. Very hard. Have a snort.
Maybe later.
And look at the mama's boy.
You gonna take that?
What?
Hey, you boys! Come back here and say that.
Grandma, what are you doing?
Who Who's this? Your 90-year-old bodyguard?
No, no, it's okay. She's kidding.
Ow!
Grandma. Oh, jeez.
I don't know why you won't tell me who did this. You know, there's no honor in protecting a bully. Okay, it's your face.
Mom, do you like your parents?
It doesn't matter how I feel about them. It's not like I can trade them in for someone else. You can't pick your parents. You're pretty much stuck with who you get.
I know.
Anyway, they're certainly not going to change. If things get too difficult, at least I can be grateful that soon they'll be gone.
Back to their own home.
Yeah.
Hey, do you know where Craig is? Your assistant manager, big guy, smells like cabbage. Thanks.
Uh-uh. It's not there. Keep looking. Lower.
Craig, Mom said you can give me a ride to study group.
Sure, sure.
What are you doing?
I was, reviewing some old security tapes. You know, looking for a pattern, see if anyone was casing the joint. You can't be too careful.
Hey, that girl's stealing something.
Oh, I didn't notice that. I'd better review her other tapes then.
Wait, are there cameras all over this place?
Oh yeah, they're everywhere. Pharmacy, ATM, the bathroom. Yep, a lot of cameras.
Is there one in the parking lot?
Whoa!
What is it?
That girl dropped a can under her car. Sorry.
Wait, stop, there's our van. She did it. She's guilty. Mom's wrong. Oh my God.
Mom's wrong. My whole world view is shaken.
I know, this is amazing. We have to go show it to her.
Wait, maybe we should save it for the next time Mom yells at us, then spring it on her.
No, I think it's better fresh.
Okay, let's go.
Wait, we need to keep a straight face.
Okay. I'm ready. No, I'm not.
Stop smiling. Come on, get up.
Sir Craig, you guys are not going to believe what I have. I have a surveillance arrangement with the manager of the mini mart across the street. We exchange tapes in order to better understand the security needs of our customers.
Short skirt, windy day?
That's code. Anywho, one of their cameras caught Lois from a different angle right before she got her ticket. See? Lois was right all along. This completely exonerates her. Isn't this great? What are you doing?
You will never, ever tell her of this.
But,
ever.
Got it.
Huh? Hold on a second. Do not operate. Agent H 16 and 47, platelets 310. These are blood test results. White count 8.4, is that right?
I will sue your ass for malpractice.
Maybe we should run another.
Give me that.
Oh my God. Look at Malcolm's hospital bill. I'd hate to think of what it'd cost if you'd actually had the operation.
Well, there goes our summer vacation.
Oh, man.
So we have to pay even though it was faking?
I wasn't faking. I'm the one who figured out they were wrong, remember?
Well, if you're such a genius, why didn't you figure it out sooner?
Well, son, you want to answer that for us all?
Nothing like 10 seconds at home to make you appreciate the hospital.
Just keep moving, Tony.
So where does this leave us?
I think it's best if we make the switch as soon as possible. We need to look at this as an opportunity.
Big opportunity being the dumb class.
Reese, this isn't what I wanted, but you haven't left us any choice.
Mom, don't do this. It's not Reese's fault. He didn't deserve an F on that test.
Malcolm, we've already had this discussion.
I saw the test. He did a good job. He deserved a B. This guy is totally out to get him.
Malcolm.
Look, I'm sorry you feel that way, but you can't blame me for Reese's shortcomings.
Mom, this is the test. Take a look at this question. What was the cause of the Great Depression? He put down Black Thursday. That's a correct answer.
No, that's only a partial answer. To get full credit, he should have included the vast overproduction in the U.S., protectionism in the foreign markets.
Overexpansion of credit and stock market speculation?
Yes, that would have been a complete answer.
Ha! You didn't read the answer because that's exactly what I wrote.
I wrote?
The royal I, as in Reese. Because I think we can all identify with what he's going through.
You took that test, didn't you? You cheated! You let him cheat for you? You gave something he wrote an F? You are out to get him! Oh, I can't wait to see you expelled or disbarred or whatever it is they do to creepy little men who abuse their power.
There is no need for name-calling. I suggest we just leave things as they are.
Oh, I don't think so.
Here's the situation. If you notify the school, then the school will find out Malcolm cheated. He'll be expelled.
Don't you threaten me.
This isn't a threat. I just don't think you'd throw away the son who achieves for, well, Reese.
You don't think I'd sacrifice this one? Let me explain something to you. I would sell Malcolm down the river in a heartbeat to save Reese.
What?
Malcolm's gonna be fine no matter what happens. Maybe he'll have to go to junior college or start off blue collar, but he'll work his way up to management eventually. Reese is the one who needs saving.
I don't believe you. No mother could ever be that callous to her own son.
Mom, please, let me come home! I'm cold and I'm hungry! Please, I'll fix the roof! I'll paint the house! I'll do anything, Mom, please! Just let me live indoors, Mom! Please, I don't want to be warm again! Mom, please!
Maybe we can work something out.
Yeah, it's cold, filthy, and dangerous, but I say we got off easy. If we all pitch in, we should be done in a week. Hey, hurry up!
I'm trying. I've got tar in my eyes.
You see, Malcolm, isn't it great when you don't have to worry about the gutters? You can just bowl and have fun!
I wish we could be alone somewhere.
Me too. Wait, I still tell you that joke. Would you like to take a walk on the beach? Feel the salt? You know what? That's not a good joke.
Mom, I don't want to do this!
Malcolm, I didn't raise you to stop trying when something is hard. You can do this! You just concentrate on those pins. You throw the ball! You are not giving up until you bowl a strike!
Your mother's right, Connie.
My name's not Connie! Okay, Mom, you want to see a strike?
Malcolm, what are you doing?
Look at me! I'm the world's greatest bowler! I care so much about bowling! Bowling is so important!
Malcolm, come back here!
You want a strike? I'll give you a strike! Here's your damn strike! Way to go, Connie! Listen, maybe you should
have been... Connie!
Oh, man, that was classic!
Okay, let's go make out.
I don't think so.
Okay, I think bowling's over. Get your jackets. I'm taking everyone home. Turn in the shoes. I'll meet you out front. Hey, Ma, can I borrow the car to go over to Richie's house?
What is it? What? You know, I realized something. You can do Francis's homework for the next 10 years, but you still can't go to Rage in the Cage if you're grounded.
What are you talking about?
Mom!
What is with you, Reese?
You've got to get in there and see what Malcolm did to Dewey. He's totally lost it.
Hey, Mom.
Where's Dewey?
He left early to go feed Craig's cat.
No way!
Huh? What is going on with you, Reese? Oh.
Dewey? Wait till you see who I am.
What happened to your face?
What happened to your pants?
Never mind that. Look who I am.
Mrs. Johnson's cat?
Yes. Mrs. Johnson's cat. Yes. Go, scoop.
These in the laundry in my shirt pocket. You put them there, didn't you? Yeah, just like you put my muddy sneaker on the kitchen table.
Guys, what's going on?
He's trying to get me grounded so I can't go with you, but he's too stupid to pull it off. We'll see who's stupid when this stupid's watching a wrestling match.
Whoa, guys, this is supposed to be a contest about love and you've twisted it into something ugly. Carry on. This too pleases me.
Look!
No, Dewey, let's go.
No, it's a mini bike.
Someone's just throwing it away? Man, that would be so cool to have.
They'd like us to stay inside the box.
This is outrageous. We're gonna freeze to death out here.
What did we do?
Maybe Malcolm can bring us a couple blankets. Come on. Malcolm! Can you get us a blanket?
It's cold out here. I'm sorry. I'm not supposed to leave my cot.
Don't think you won't suffer the consequences later, mister.
Ah, you could fry an egg on my forehead.
If you're getting up, would you get me another lemonade?
Ready?
Oh. Stevie's house has air conditioning. Let's get some. Maybe I can give you a call.
Maybe. Whoa, look at that guy. Do you know him?
Who, that Nikes? Of course not. Do you want to help me choose a surfboard?
Okay.
Malcolm! Oh, for the love of... Excuse me. Oh, God, it's not me. It's the suit. I am a normal person. I'm here with my family. My son is right over the mountain. Come!
No. I know how this looks, but I'm telling you, it's
Malcolm! Wait, no. This is a complete misunderstanding.
Registered sex offender! A registered sex offender! And for what? For some trampy girl? For
Mom, please! I feel terrible! I completely understand what I did. I sold out my own father for a girl. It's like the worst thing I've ever done. We both agree I'm a terrible person.
For some girl you don't even know, who wouldn't give you the time of day. That's the gratitude you showed your father.
Hey, maybe I'm the good one after all. Here, Mom, for your throat. I put a little honey in it.
That man gets one vacation a year, and this is how you start it. You go and make it right. Hello?
Dad's probably not that mad at me. I mean, it's not like I personally shoved him.
Hi, Malcolm. Me and my naked friends got tired of waiting for you. You don't want that jerk Reese to have all the fun, do you?
What happened? You catch something?
No.
We're not gonna catch anything.
I know. It's just really awful, isn't it? I don't think there's a darn fish in this whole lake. You know what? It doesn't matter. It's just nice being out here with you.
Dad? You know the other day at the store when I pretended not to know you?
Yeah. That was a new low.
Well, there was this girl.
Really?
I'm sorry.
I know. Oh, looks like you got a nibble.
Attaboy, set the hook. Set the hook.
Yeah, let him run. Let him run.
Take it on. Here we
go. Okay, now reel him. Reel him. Attaboy, attaboy. Look at that. Come to Papa, baby.
You betcha.
Oh, yeah! Ooh, that's a striper! Look at that beauty! Way to go, Malcolm!
Thanks, Dad.
Oh, look at that! He's 4 pounds if he's an ounce!
Yeah.
Huh. Isn't this your brother's shirt?
Yes, 1 to the 11th.
Did you know I can count to a million by prime numbers?
I can too!
So can I! It's easy!
That's not necessary.
2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31! Now by hundreds! 101, 211, 207, 401, 503, 601, 701!
Okay, that is enough. 1 to the 11th.
5,000. 1,009. 2,003. Now back 500. 2,011. 2,203.
No! Where are you going, number 3?
It's hot. It's hot and I'm stupid. I'm stupid too.
Everybody please remain seated.
I'm zero. Zero.
Boy, that's quite a show for your first week here. You were right. You can't beat the system. But you sure can break it.
Could you pass the beans, please? Thank you. You're welcome.
Help.
All right, boy, get it up.
Think for once we could have a civilized conversation during dinner free of sound effects?
Your mother's right. I don't think it's asking too much for us to have some nice dinner conversation.
Malcolm, how was school today?
History class was cool.
Really? Tell us about it.
Jimmy Perkins kicked the crap out of Fred Nason right outside our window.
He beat up Fred Nason? That dude's huge.
I know, I couldn't believe it.
Really?
Fred knocked Jimmy's hat off, and Jimmy turned and punched him in the face like five times in a row in like a second. Fred fell in the bush, and then he just started hitting him and hitting him and hitting him. It was way cool.
Jimmy Perkins is crazy.
It's like I've always told you boys, crazy beats big every time. So how was
you would not.
I would too.
No clothes at all. Go all the way across the street and ring Mrs. Conlin's doorbell.
Yeah, I would totally do it, but you don't have $10.
Do we?
No underwear, no clothes at all.
Of course.
What are you doing?
You said no clothes. I'll be right back, losers.
I never thought I'd do it.
I guess he outsmarted us. You opened her gate, right?
Of course.
Sit! Look at yourself. They put you on probation. Probation! If you do just one more thing wrong, they're gonna kick you out of school! Do you have any idea how serious this is? Is this who you want to be? You want to be some little lapdog who ruins his life for some girl? For God's sake, Malcolm, you beat up a foreign exchange student! Poor little Zadok left his country to get away from this kind of abuse! Are you even listening to me?
Yes, I'm listening. But you know what, Mom? I've got bigger problems. You may not have noticed, but I've been screwing up a lot lately. All because of some stupid girl. I'm on probation. I beat up a kid who doesn't even speak English. I'm going through a lot right now, and you don't even care!
No. No. Wait. No. No.
Give me that. No. 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 Wait. No. No.
Hi, boys. Got a second? You boys really have a pretty good life.
Uh-oh.
Spend your days flying kites, playing video games. It's about time you found something to do to enrich your lives.
When do we have kites?
I could never live with myself if my boys grew up to be selfish little pigs. So, I decided to volunteer you to do a little charity work. You can choose between helping old people or helping poor people. Or I can make you do both.
Okay, old people. What can be hard about old people? Poor people, we want
the good work, boys.
All right, I'll be back in 2 hours, during which time I suggest you think about the horrible, thoughtless, whatever it is you did to deserve this punishment.
That's just it. We didn't do anything.
Mom said we needed to build character.
Your character, right? Well, see that you do.
What are you doing?
Trading again. A backpack for a backpack.
Dewey, wait. A yo-yo isn't equal to a Game Boy.
What if I throw in my Mighty Man?
Okay. Two twists for one. Seems fair.
Yeah. I mean, just as long as what we trade is equal, it seems like... Whoa. Check these out. Is this fair?
Think of it this way. When you add in the value of the work we're doing, they're still way ahead.
Okay, Steve is looking for some Pam Grier memorabilia, if he can keep it here.
As long as he's got the money, the church doesn't care.
And the guy at the liquor store says he'll take the bread maker.
You know what? We're up to $159.
What do you think we should do with it?
I say we buy a saddle. Once we have the saddle, Mom and Dad can't say no to the horse.
I don't want a horse. We all worked for this. I say we vote on what we get. Do we?
Can God see everything we do?
What?
Mrs. Potts said God sees everything we do.
Yeah, Dewey. God can magically see through roofs. What are you worried about? We're not doing anything wrong.
Then how come we have money?
Well, sometimes when you do good things happen for you. Satisfied? I mean, think of it this way, Dewey. People are still getting the things they need, and, okay, we do have some money. But, the church does too. So, I mean, no one's really getting hurt, and... This is bad.
I say once we get the saddle, we should just quit.
We're not getting the saddle. This was a mistake from the beginning. I should have known something was wrong when you started making so much sense.
This is your fault. You're the one that's supposed to be smart enough to keep us out of trouble. And that's why you're going to hell.
We're all going to hell.
You guys seen the remote for...
What's going on?
Dad, we've done something terrible. It might just be the worst thing we've ever done.
All right, just calm down. Let's talk this through. It can't be that bad.
You've been stealing money from the church!
And maybe some merchandise.
Oh! Oh! Well, you boys have been taking stereos and toys! Is that cheese? Oh, God! Oh! Oh my God!
Do we get a washcloth?
My boys are thieves!
Oh. Here, go, Dad. Nice and even.
You stole air! What is wrong with you boys? Do you ever stop and think of the consequences of anything that you do? Do you realize the shame that you're going to bring upon our entire family? Do you?
Forget that. What's Mom gonna...
Everything is new. Everything is open to you. Please don't ever take that for granted. Make every moment the best you possibly can. God, I am so proud of all of you. You kids are the best thing I've ever done. You'll never know how much I love you. Maybe you're not supposed to. Sleep well, my little angels.
This was amazing. I made out with a sophomore. I am so far ahead of schedule. Did you see the TV set fly off the roof into the pool? That was me. Man, I hope you get grounded next week. Ridiculously hard over a little mud on the floor.
You two are the most ungrateful, badly behaved, inconsiderate boys ever born. How could you be so heartless?
What is heartless about going to a party with a bunch of slutty girls? Be cool.
You were at a party while we were here worrying?
Can I have a napkin?
I cannot believe you two.
All right, that's it. You are grounded for the rest of the school year.
You can't do that. You're crazy!
You do not talk to your mother that way, ever! You will show her nothing but the love and respect she deserves, whether I am here or not!
This family sucks! You are ruining our lives! I wish you were dead! What was that all about?
I don't know. She usually just says, Mom, Dad, we have something to say.
We know why you've been crying so much lately. You don't have to protect us from this.
We think getting a divorce is a great idea.
What?
You don't have to stay together for us. We've known for years your marriage was a sham.
I mean, clearly your relationship isn't working. Mom, you need someone who's going to control you better, and Dad needs someone younger.
You both deserve some happiness. In fact, I think we all do.
Amen to that.
So I guess we should be going to a motel with Dad or something?
Our bags are packed. And don't worry, Mom, you'll still be part of our lives. We'll see you every other weekend, and feel free to call us anytime.
We've already discussed it. I get full custody.
Reese has had the remote for 4 hours. That's 4 hours of mindless crap in 5 second increments. You go to the bathroom, you lose the remote.
Fine. I can wait.
I don't know. You drank a lot of soda. It must really be pushing up against the walls of your bladder.
Not gonna work.
And then I had 4 glasses of Dad's iced tea. He just kept pouring and pouring.
Not gonna work.
The equivalent of 3 semi-trailers of water pour over the falls every second.
Not gonna work. Not gonna work!
Turns out, this is way better than anything on TV. Hey, this is supposed to be the Dewey from both of us.
I picked it out.
I stepped in it!
Mom, how nice to see you home.
I have had it!
What are you doing?
I am taking everything. Every present, every decoration, every treat. I am locking it in the garage. Every single Christmas, you scream or burn or break or destroy, and I am putting a stop to it!
She's stealing Christmas!
Mom, you can't do this.
Yeah, this is the last year Dewey will believe in Santa Claus.
What?
If you boys behave until Christmas morning, there will be a Christmas morning. Otherwise, these are going back to the store, and Christmas will be canceled.
You want to cancel Christmas? You're bluffing.
Yes, we're doing great.
You're so good at this.
Stop. What are you doing?
I'm sorry. So just tell me, what's your big problem with me?
Malcolm!
No, seriously, I want to know. Am I too short? Am I too smart?
Malcolm, can we please drop this?
I'm smart, okay? Is that a crime? I'm sorry, I'm not a moron like Gary Spindler.
Malcolm, stop it. What are you doing?
I want you to tell me why you don't like me.
Why are you doing this?
I want a straight answer.
God, I can't believe I liked you in the third grade.
You liked me in the third grade? I knew it. I wasn't crazy. You did like me. So what the hell has changed? Tell me. I defy you to tell me.
Nothing. That's the problem. You're still the same obsessive, whining know-it-all who doesn't listen to anyone.
But you did like me in the third grade.
Malcolm, I don't like you. Can you get that through your head? Before, I just didn't have a crush on you. And now, I can't stand you. So, you want me to tell you why I don't like you? You want me to tell you why I like nice, funny Gary Spindler and absolutely despise bitter, annoying Malcolm? Do you?
Look.
Well, I'm gonna tell you. There is something wrong with you. I don't know how you do it. You're cute, smart, funny, and somehow you managed to mess that up. Like today, it was an awkward situation, but it would have passed. But you just kept picking at it and picking at it until it turned this big, horrible thing! There's something wrong inside you! There's something rotten at the core of your personality! You're just off! That's not even the worst thing
I'm so sorry, Malcolm. I just started talking and I couldn't stop and I said all those mean things. I didn't even mean half of them. Who am I to say their kids would be screwed up? I mean, you might not even have kids. Are you okay?
I think I can stop crying now. Can you hand me more leaves?
Oh, Malcolm.
No, really, I'll be fine.
No, Malcolm, That's poison oak.
Of course it is.
I mean, when you're better. Oh, come on, Malcolm. It's not that bad. Give me a smile. Are you smiling? I can't tell.
I'm smiling.
Settlement. This receiver works in both SRS 5.1 and DTS. Unidirectional subwoofer for surround sound. Progressive scan DVD player. Plays both AIFF and MP3 formats on either CDs or CDRs. I figured you'd be comfortable with this level of electronics. I mean, the guys at the store couldn't find the graphic equalizers with two hands and a flashlight.
You dragged me over here to hook up your stereo? Can you get one of your friends to help you do this?
And tick off the other friends I didn't ask? Malcolm, this goes far beyond just a stereo. This is going to be the greatest entertainment center ever. Have you ever wanted to be the best at something? I mean, not just good, I don't mean great, I mean the absolute best.
I don't know.
Well, I have. Ever since I was a kid watching Land of the Lost on my tiny black and white 6-inch, I knew there'd be a day when I could create my own high-def universe, a magical realm where fantasy and technology intersect in my every whim, because I am the king.
So your lifelong dream was to become the world's best TV watcher?
Yeah.
I'm in.
Malcolm, you can't connect those cables. Their impedance values aren't equal. You'll get a reflected transmission.
That's what the high-speed scan modulation is for. Trust me, 480p is more than enough to take care of it.
But then I can't use the analog preamp to play my SACDs. You're tired. You're not thinking right.
Did it ever occur to you that I might be using single-ended interconnects for the front, left, right speakers?
Are you mad? You can't do that.
Just watch me. I know it sounds weird, but this is the most fulfilling conversation I've had in weeks.
Another half turn. Easy. Easy. Don't strip it.
Got it.
Beautiful. Now all you have to do is adjust it and we're done.
Congratulations.
I gotta admit, it was pretty hairy there, especially with those hub connectors.
Stripping that extra quarter inch off the copper leads was inspired.
I hardly even remember it. I was running on pure adrenaline.
You know what, Craig? I gotta tell you. This was a lot of fun. I actually enjoyed spending time with you. You didn't have to lie to get me over here.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, okay. But you wouldn't now. I guess what I'm trying to say is, you know, I'm sorry for all the times we made you miserable.
It's okay.
You're a good guy. I like you.
Run down and check the signal, will you?
Okay.
And try not to screw it up, buddy.
We're getting 42%! Try moving the dish a little to the right. A little more! 57! Up a little more! 61!
A low-speed chase involving a teenager, a driver's ed car, and what appears to be a hostage.
It all happened so fast. He just took off. With my checkbook and all my financial papers in the car. That's not an excuse. I just hope that B of A understands the situation.
Although the hostage seems to be unharmed, it's only a matter of time before the police decide to end it, one way or the other.
Oh, no.
We're on the line.
Now they're never going to let me drive.
How's it looking? Malcolm? Malcolm! I can't hear you. You're not watching without me, are you? Malcolm!
The Plaza Burger, the Maine Lobster, medium rare porterhouse, large platter of French fries, and a complete dessert cart. Parents certainly have interesting taste in food.
Yeah, they do.
Actually, I'm gonna need one of your parents to sign that.
I left the tip blank. Why don't you put in whatever you think is fair?
Bon appetit.
Dewey, your dinner's here!
Here you go, Reese.
Thank you, Malcolm. So this is what a $24 hamburger looks like. I thought it would be as big as my head.
Why don't we have a jacuzzi tub at home?
Because that would make us happy.
You know what? Forget about that place. Tonight, this is our home.
You got a lobster?
Yes, I think I deserve a lobster. We all deserve something nice for once.
Well, this dinner was expensive. I wonder what Dad's credit limit is.
Let's find out.
It's about time. We called for chocolate syrup like 30 minutes ago.
Hello, Malcolm.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Beat it, Vicky.
We'll finish the cuffs later.
Okay, boys, get your things. We're going home.
No, we're not going back there.
Well, you can't stay in this hotel room forever. What are you gonna do? Live under a bridge and steal food out of dumpsters?
I don't know, but we're not going home. We've had it with the way you treat us, and we've had it with all the yelling.
You are a terrible influence on us. All you ever do is scream.
And order us around.
There's something wrong with this family. Family should have some way of communicating besides yelling.
Okay, everybody, calm down. I understand what you're saying. I am not going to yell. I am not going to scream. We are capable of talking about this without raising our voices. Now, boys, I want you to understand, I'm sorry about what happened. But you have to understand, I get a little emotional when I learn that my oldest son was acting like an idiot and throwing his life away. Now, that doesn't mean...
Stop talking about him like that! Francis is my heart!
Okay, we're even. Everyone's fine and there's no need for escalation. Isn't it beautiful when things work out?
Yeah, I'd say this has gone pretty well. I mean, considering we got off to a rocky start, we couldn't have asked for a better ending.
Get your wife out of my sight. She called you my wife. That's progress.
I can't believe you, Dewey. How could you do this?
When is she going to stop? I'm starving. Go get some food.
I'm not going out there.
Sorry doesn't cut it, young man.
This was a good idea. Just wish you had told me earlier. I was hiding outside for...
Hard drive?
Nothing. He erased everything.
No, he just thinks he did. He may have deleted all the programs, but he didn't format the drive. They never do. There it is. Let's check out what he's got in here.
Let's go through his emails.
Why? It's Ed. What's he gonna... Oh my God. Eddie, last night was amazing. You touched me places my husband never knew existed.
T. Goodwin. That's Mrs. Goodwin from down the block.
That's horrible. They're both married. And fat.
Look at this one. Edward. Just saying your name turns me to jelly.
That's Mrs. Fisher. Mrs. Conlon, Mrs. Wilson, Mrs. Belt. He's living with half the women in this neighborhood. Here's one from old Mrs. Swanbeck.
Open the picture attachment.
Ugh. Stevie.
You were supposed to meet me at the library.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. You know, I actually found something decent on Ed's computer.
The Verts?
Yeah. You create a virtual family, put them in different situations, and the computer plays out their lives. I'm putting in the characters right now.
Is that your mom?
Not yet. Reese.
Make sure you capture the blackness of his soul.
Aggressiveness, 10. Hygiene, 0. Okay, now me. Appearance, 9. No, 10. A 10 for intelligence and social skills, 10.
Too bad it doesn't go higher.
I have social skills, jackass. Okay, it's dinner time. Where's Malcolm?
Looking at himself in the mirror. He's... Start working?
Just one more second. This is really interesting. I just made my mom quit her crappy job and go to law school. It's less money, but her happiness level went way up. I made my dad quit too. All he's doing is working on neighbors' cars, but check out his happiness level. But I still think they could be happier. Let's send Reese to China.
What are you changing about Malcolm?
Nothing, he's fine.
He's burning himself with a cigarette.
Just a phase.
Stop this.
Stupid game. This is ridiculous. Everybody in my family is like perfect. My mom is president, Reese is married to 6 supermodels, and my dad used all his money to fund a search for extraterrestrials. Nothing I do has any effect whatsoever. If I give them money, if I take it away, if I make them ugly, if I make them Canadian, everything works out beautifully for them and horrible for me.
Dewey just became Pope.
And I weigh 500 pounds. That's it. I'm just gonna have to kill them. Go to counter, get knife, kill them. No, don't make yourself a sandwich. Kill, kill. No, not yourself. Don't kill. Don't kill. You stupid fat bastard. Ugh! This means no. Oh my God. How could a night that started out so badly get even worse? Wait, don't panic. Think for a second. No, this is good. This is sensible.
I make those kind of statements and just assume that she knows I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. And you know what? That's not right. She deserves better than that.
That's all I needed to hear.
I'm gonna call that woman up and tell her just how much I love her. Hello? Earl, is that you? Yo, what the hell are you doing in my house? Hello? I'm going to go home now, because I got a thing to do tomorrow. Yeah, take care, baby. Talk to you
tomorrow. Well, I guess the game's over.
Yeah. You know, I've wondered why Earl never came to the game.
Dad! I've tried to be understanding about all this, but there is a limit. You have a right to know what's going on in this house.
Dewey, now is not the time to be it.
Normally, I don't mind being a snitch, but this even makes me sad. This is what your son is up to.
Stevie! What are you doing?
Where's Reese?
I was about to take a scented bath. Is something going on?
Laptop! Put your sweater on!
Dad,
Stevie, how could
it's not what it looks like.
Well, it looks like she was on your lap.
Oh my God, his head exploded.
Abe, are you okay?
I think so.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry. Is everyone okay? I mean, what was that?
Start with you.
Well, it's like this.
So let me see. You found the gun, didn't tell your father. Handled it, hid it inside the house. Handled it again to move it, and tried to destroy it with a hacksaw. And at no point did you contact the police until after the gun went off.
Yes.
What'd you say your IQ was?
Man, what a night. When that thing went off, I couldn't believe how scared I was.
You were scared.
Hey, I was way more scared than you guys.
You kidding me? I screamed like a little girl.
Police! I could have broke glass the way I screamed.
You sounded like a hero compared to how I screamed.
In order to break free of the Earth's atmosphere, a rocket ship must attain speeds of upwards of 25,000 miles per hour.
Bull. If they went that fast, they would just be squashed in the back of their seats. They wouldn't float around. You're confusing acceleration with velocity. You feel it when you first start going faster, but once you're up to speed, you don't even notice. I mean, right now, we're on a planet, that's spinning at 1,000 miles per hour. And that's just rotational velocity. We're also traveling around the sun at almost 67,000 miles per hour. And then the whole solar system is hurtling through the galaxy, which is hurtling away from all the other galaxies because the universe is expanding.
Whee!
I need to give you a tour of the police station. Did you know that the mirrors in the interrogation room are two-way? It's a good thing they didn't have that before.
For heroism and meritorious action, Reese, I'm so proud of you.
Okay, Dewey, are you finally gonna be able to go to sleep now? You saw all the policemen and how strong the bars are.
Yeah, but...
And you saw that the police station is much too big for a helicopter to carry it away to a secret hideout under the sea.
But...
No buts, Dewey. That guy is in a jail cell. He's not going anywhere.
I wouldn't bet on him. With our legal system, he's probably back in the streets right now.
Dewey.
Mom, Dad, this whole thing's got me thinking. I mean, usually those cops are throwing me in the back of their squad cars. But today, they were all clapping for me.
Well, you're a real hero.
And it was really cool, you know? Protecting you guys, saving your lives.
Thanks again.
And it's made me realize, for the first time in my life, I know what my purpose is. I think I found my calling. Mom, Dad, I want to be a pig.
Go to sleep.
I'm still scared. Read me a story. Please.
I've already read you every book in this place.
Please.
Aardvark, a burrowing mammal of southern Africa. Myocardium, the muscle tissue of the heart. It's all right. It was just me turning off the light.
Where are you? Come your feet back. Come on, you son of a...
Sorry. Go back to sleep.
Kamingo. Well, I've been awake for a week straight. First 96 hours were tough, but I really think I'm starting to get my second wind. Who needs sleep anyway? Just a waste of time. They say that Thomas Edison, he only got like, well, he didn't... What was I talking about? Never mind. Stop being the point a long time.
Nothing I do ever has any meaning, then I can't care about anything, which makes me feel even worse. How am I supposed to ever feel happy?
Kid, I'm a zoo clown. Now buy a giraffe or go to hell.
See, Dewey, there's a guy who understands.
Malcolm, you're at the zoo. You have a popsicle. How can you be unhappy?
I wanted grape.
Tigers! Where are they? They're not here. What a gif!
See, that's what it means. The one thing you were excited about closed.
Maybe they're down here.
Or maybe there never were any tigers. And they just put up the signs to build a sense of disappointment.
Ah!
Dewey!
Okay.
You idiot! What the hell's wrong with you? Come on. Let's get out of here before we get caught.
For 20 minutes?
I still mean it.
Do you think he's mad?
I don't know. I don't think it matters. Just stay quiet and try not to look like meat.
Hey! I don't think you kids are supposed to be messing around down there. Yeah, thank you. Would you mind going to tell somebody that we're down here, please?
Oh, for the love of God!
I don't think those kids are supposed to be down there.
Get us out of here!
Okay. Calm down. We've trained for situations like this, and there are standard procedures we...
About which one of us was going to be eaten by a tiger. Now we can relax.
Okay, kids. The tigers didn't go for the steaks we threw down. The problem is they're attracted to you because you're alive. Like they're natural prey.
There's a butt coming, right?
Well, no. But we have things under control. We're going to fire tranquilizer darts at the tigers.
How long do they take to work?
Less than 2 minutes.
So the plan is to piss them off and keep them awake just long enough so they can take it out on us?
Hold on a second.
Okay, these people are idiots.
Malcolm, it'll be okay.
Yeah, do I hope so too, but...
I'm not hoping. I know it'll be fine.
You can't know that.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. I do. I know it'll be fine.
Okay, just sit tight a few more minutes. Apparently they had a similar situation in D.C. We're trying to find out exactly what went wrong there. But the main thing is, everything's gonna be okay.
See? I think Stanley's getting angry.
You named them?
That's Stanley. That's French Fry.
Dewey, I want to tell you something. I love you.
Don't say that!
It's true. I love you so much.
You're just saying that because you think we're going to die. This is all part of your hating life thing.
You're wrong. I love life. I realize that now. It's imperfect, but I love that too. And I love Mom and Dad and Francis and even Reese. I love you all.
Stop it! We're going to be fine!
Why don't you stop it, Dewey? Why don't you stop pretending everything's great and tell me you love me, okay?
We're not going to die!
Yes, we are! We're gonna die! This is the ultimate proof that I was right all along! And I don't need some stupid little kid giving me fake reassurances!
Well, I don't need some crybaby brother taking all the fun out of being at the zoo!
Oh my God!
You're just in a bad mood. We'll get out of this.
No, we won't. Give it up, Dewey. Superman isn't gonna fly in here and save us. In your face, goat! Who's laughing?
Go, go, go!
Okay, kid, inside!
Open up.
Here you go.
Thanks.
Hi, I can take over from here.
Thank you very much. Excuse me, I can't use this book. I need to switch.
What did you do?
Nothing.
You can't bring the book back in this condition.
No, I just got it like this.
I don't think so. If you want another book, you're gonna have to pay $40 for it. Next!
Mom. You have to talk to this lady. She won't let me return this book.
Oh, my God. What did you do to your pants?
What?
Oh, for crying out loud. How did you get a stain there already?
Mom, come on.
It wasn't there this morning.
Mom, stop. It's no big deal.
No big deal? You begged me for these pants. You almost started crying in the store when I wasn't going to buy them for you. And now, look what you did to them.
That looks like that's coming from the inside.
Mom, leave me alone. You're embarrassing me.
Oh, I am not embarrassing you.
Would you be embarrassed by this? No, see? Come on. See if we can find some club soda and get that out.
Justice. Here we go. I don't want to be a stickler, but you don't have the right decal for this lot.
Malcolm, stop this. You don't have a license.
That's okay. I'm just going to crash into my mom's car.
This is crazy, Malcolm! This is the stupidest thing I've ever heard!
No, it's not. It's smart. I just take this car and crash into that car. Then I'll be in military school just like Francis was. It'll be paradise. Somebody! With me! Stop him!
Love of God, your shirt tail's stuck in the door!
Take me with you!
What's going on?
I don't know, man. Stop!
I won't let you do this. I would rather die than be left alone with Mom.
Get out of the way.
No, you can run me over. I don't care.
Malcolm, if you do this, I will never have sex with you again.
Again?
They had sex?
He had sex with her?
Her kid had sex? She's a slut.
She's a big slut.
Oh my God, what a slut.
Wow, I could really learn a lesson from this, but all I can think about right now is how the whole school is convinced that I had sex.
Get out of that car this instant! What the heck is wrong with you?
Here, take my pancakes. Oh, and I did your laundry. I fold them warm so they wouldn't wrinkle. Reese, I'm not gonna tell you about it. It didn't even happen. Okay. Where didn't it happen?
Do you want to sit down on? Because I was thinking the 50, but it's kind of a long walk.
There's nothing to be nervous about, Stevie. I'll dance the first couple of dances with you.
Hey, stop blaming yourself. That guy's a complete jerk. We're gonna throw away his beer, get someone to take you home, and you should totally dump that guy. That's what I would have done if I hadn't shut off my brain all week. Here's what I really did. And demons are your brethren. I'm sick of you always having an edge just because you're an idiot and I'm smart and understand about consequences. I can be just as vicious and short-sighted as you.
Oh, yeah. I'm really scared. Why don't you just...
Oh, what'd you do?
I sunk to your level. And I have to say, it feels good.
Ow! Ow!
You should have seen Reese. It was hysterical.
Are you sure you want to push him?
It's the only way to get through to his primitive little monkey brain. He has to know that I'm not gonna back down. What is this? Oh my God.
If you can be vicious, I can be smart.
How many copies did you make?
I don't know. How many copies are there in a pack of 500 sheets?
This isn't over, Reese.
I don't know why you're so upset. Look at you going like a big boy.
Hey, get out of here. I'm busy. I'll be quick. You know, while I was ripping down all those flyers, I was racking my brain trying to come up with some way to get back at you. And I began to wonder, what's the point? No matter how hard I try, nothing ever stops you. Maybe you're just better at this than I am.
Well, yeah.
Then again, maybe we should ask your friends what they think.
What?
Your friends. These are your friends, aren't they? You're always hanging out with them, or near them anyway. Hey, do any of you know this kid's name? This kid right here. Do any of you know his name? But he's always following you around. You never noticed him before? So he's been sitting right next to you for months, just pretending to be your friend. Wow, that's sad. Well, his name's Reese. And guess what? I'm better than you. I win, it's over. The humiliation is the only thing that jerk understands.
Fine.
Why are you taking his side? Oh, a birthday card. $5 Canadian. Pretty good for grandma. So, I'll have the rest of my birthday money on Saturday, so I can give you the $300 for the computer win. Dear Malcolm, haha, now I win. Your friend, Reese.
Try you as an adult.
Car number 15, no bumping. Return to the pit.
What the hell? What are you doing?
You had no right. You stole from me. That was my money.
Fine. Let's see. I've done 63 laps.
keep the change.
Carly, let's be courteous.
It ends here, Reese. I don't care about the money. I don't care about my birthday. I don't care about your safety or mine. I don't care about anything except making you suffer!
Well, I don't care either.
Fine! Let's you care the least the most! This is a game of chicken Reese is not gonna win! I'm too angry to blink! When he sees my face, he's gonna know he doesn't have a chance!
He's often flying as he guns a car around the track, scamming down the pedal like he's never coming back. Adventure's waiting just ahead!
He'll stop. I know he'll stop! Maybe this wasn't such a good...
I should have told the doctor to sew fur and tails on you boys, because you're animals! Only animals would be easier, because then I could have you fixed.
For all the good it does, you're grounded. Again.
Thanks for getting me grounded on my birthday.
Oh, boo-hoo, I was grounded on my birthday.
I was just standing up for myself. There is such a thing as justice, you know.
Well, there is such a thing as shut up.
Stop it. Malcolm, do you remember what you did for your birthday last year?
Nothing, I was grounded then too.
And what about your birthday?
You grounded me after I smashed Malcolm's face into the cake.
And your birthday before that?
Pretty much this. Wait, when did you push me off the pony?
Do you realize that neither of you has had a birthday party in his entire life? Don't you think that's sad? Every chance you have had for a little happiness, a little something special, you threw it away. At some point, this has to stop. Is revenge ever worth it? Is it worth it now? Do you feel happy? There's no reason to compete with each other. We love you both the same. There are no favorites.
Come on! You know I can shoot! Why won't you put me in? For God's sake, that's it! Time out! All right, everybody up, come on! All right, you yo-yos. Do you want to know why we can't beat this team?
Because you're not letting anyone shoot! They're just passing the ball back and forth!
Nobody on this team has any heart. Not a man. You know, when the Allies first hit the beach at Iwo Jima, they didn't have better weapons than the Germans. They had something more than firepower.
Have you completely lost your mind? Put me in! Let me shoot the ball!
Not one of you has been able to forget about the water in your boots or the sand in your mess kit long enough to focus on the success of the entire unit!
Tell him to shut up and put you in! Tell him! Tell him!
Malcolm, do you think you can follow my game plan?
No, because you're a freaking idiot! I hate you! I want to kill you in death in your shallow grave! That's my game plan!
All right, get in there.
Thanks.
Ew. Dude, that's gross.
Oh my, hey, look.
A peptic ulcer? How did you manage to get a peptic ulcer? The doctor said you have the stomach lining of a 60-year-old air traffic controller. You are a teenager, for God's sake. What do you have to be stressed about?
For your information, I just spent the past 3 hours on a gurney next to a guy who was still trying to smoke out of the hole in his neck. And the jackass who put in this IV couldn't find a vein with two hands and a flashlight. My call button doesn't work. These stupid sheets are itchy. There's only one channel on the TV, and what's this about a...
Hey, I brought you some food.
I can't believe I'm being forced to live in an attic, living off someone else's table scraps.
Do you mind if I sit with you for a little bit? I'm really pissed at my dad right now.
You're pissed at your dad?
Could you listen for a sec? My dad just told me that he's dragging me on some camping trip with him and Trish. I can't spend an entire weekend in a tent with that woman.
He provoked the whole thing. He could have stopped me from walking out of the door if he'd really wanted to.
Malcolm, I think it would be a really good idea if you would listen to me right now. Do you understand? If you listen to what I'm saying, then you can give it some thought, and then we can talk it out in a way that's gonna help me, and then I can do the same for you. And then we can have a conversation that actually matters.
No. He acts like a big man. What was he trying to prove?
That's it.
That's what?
I can't take this anymore. You are the most selfish, thoughtless person that I have ever seen. From now on, I am not your girlfriend.
You're breaking up with me?
You have killed everything I have ever felt for you. It's over.
But what am I gonna do?
I never want to see you again.
So my dad kicked me out of the house, then Nikki broke up with me.
I don't know how long ago it was. I can't remember if these mean hours or days. That's Nikki. Did you hear that? That's her talking. What's she laughing about? She can't be laughing. She's not laughing. She's crying, just like my dad. They're all suffering now. Okay, maybe Nikki could have at least left me a paper cup or something up here. Just wish she'd come back to say hello. I miss talking to her. What was gonna be her little secret? She's so incredible. I can't believe she ever liked me. I had Nikki and I had a family. What happened? How did it ever get like this? Oh my God, I'm horrible. No wonder my dad kicked me out of the house. I'm annoying and selfish. Nikki and my family are lucky. At least they get to get away from me. I'm stuck here with myself. Wait a second. I don't have to be like this. I can change. I can totally change. From now on, I'll just listen to what people say. I'll be friendly. I'll be considerate. Yeah. Yeah. I like this new Malcolm. That's her. What's she talking about? That's a guy's voice. There's a guy in her room. A guy in her room.
I am telling you, he's not here.
Be good. There'll be hell to pay if Jellybean wakes up from her massage and doesn't see me on the table next to her.
Oh my God. Is that an Ortair?
It's a Nortair 680B. It's like the first personal computer ever made. You have an interest in this type of stuff, don't you?
There aren't many of these left. I'll give you $5 for it.
Yeah, right. I checked online. This is in mint condition. It's worth at least $1,300.
Deal. No takebacks. Double black magic. Tap it, bomb it, flush it down the toilet. You understand it's going to take me a couple days to get the money.
That's exactly what I want. I want you to buy it this Saturday at our garage sale, in front of everybody, with cash. You're going to react in horror when I tell you Reese was going to throw this in the trash. And then you're going to tell everyone they should have listened to me all along.
You know, right now you're sounding a lot like a James Bond villain.
Me? There's nothing wrong with me. I'm fine. And right. And right. And on Saturday, everyone's going to know it.
Okay, but these revenge plans have a way of backfiring. Word to the wise, if you ever make someone an X-Lax milkshake, don't.
Do you have a microwave for sale?
No. Well, actually, yes. Yes, we do. Follow me.
Excuse me, Malcolm. It's me, Craig. What's that you're holding in your hands?
You mean this thing that I've been trying to save, that Reese has insisted all along was mere junk?
Mere junk? Why, your brother couldn't be more wrong, nor you more right. Please allow me to buy it from you for the princely sum
of... Come with me.
Dad, what are you doing? Craig, get back here! Mom,
what are you doing with that? I ordered you to throw this away!
Let go of it, you idiot!
Oh!
Restore, you stupid jackass! You don't even know what you're doing!
That is enough out of you! Are you really so insecure that you can't stand anyone else getting any attention? Your brother has worked so hard to make this yard sale a success, he doesn't need you undermining him at every turn.
Mom, you have to listen to me. We have a Nortair 680B. It's a type of computer that was built in 1976. There's only a few in existence, and Craig is gonna give us $1,300 for it.
$1,300? Oh my God! What are you doing?
I have a lot of things to sell, and I don't have time to argue with this bozo. I've got a jet ski on hold, and the place closes at 6.
What are you talking about?
I'm buying a jet ski with my yard sale money.
That money isn't yours. He's going to rebuild our bedroom wall.
But you said I was in charge. That means I get the money.
No, it doesn't.
Then why the hell would I want to be in charge?
Reese, this is helping you become a better person by building your self-esteem, which you are obviously going to need if you are stupid enough to throw away $1,300 that this family desperately needs.
Understand. And if they do understand, they just make fun of it. But why should I expect them to be any different than the rest of the world? Let's face it, everyone on this planet is a brain-dead, butt-scratching half-wit. Bite us.
How could you possibly think that the Nimzowitsch defense would work against me? You tried it 2 games ago, and I slaughtered you. You tried it 4 games ago, and I slaughtered you. Seriously, how do you find your way home at night? Hey, what? Where are you going? What? Oh, okay. Who wants to play? Eddie, come on. I tell you what, I'll hit myself in the head with a rock. I'll even it out. No? Chubbo, you can eat with one hand. Play with the other. Oh, I can't believe this. You're all cowards. Hey, funny looking kid. You want to learn how to play chess?
No, thanks.
Come on. Look, it's not that hard. See, this one looks like a pretty little horsey.
I know what a knight is. I also know how to counter a Nimzowitsch defense without leaving my queen's bishop wide open. Your whole left flank was Swiss cheese.
Hey, junior champion, read your Kasparov. The second you go after my bishop, you can kiss your rook and 2 pawns. Bye-bye! Oh, okay, I get it. You're scared to play me!
Yeah, I'm really scared of some troll in the park beating me at chess.
Evidently you are!
Now you're confusing fear with pity. Fear triggers a fight-or-flight response, while pity allows me to turn my back and walk away with a sadness for your misery.
Gotta kick your ass!
All right, that's it. Couldn't see that coming. Another draw.
Hey, Casey Kasem, why don't you do everybody a favor and turn that crap down?
It's not loud.
I didn't say it was loud. I said it was crap.
So, is this all you do every day? Just hang out in the park and play chess with strangers?
No. I also enjoy long walks on the beach and bubble baths. Of course, I'd have to say my greatest turn-on is honesty.
So basically, the only human contact you have is playing chess with people who can't stand you.
I hate to burst your little after-school special bubble, but I'm not some kind of loser. I have a perfect life. I have a great job selling toner over the phone. I make a few calls, bing, bang, bing, it's 10 o'clock. I've got the rest of the day to myself.
You can't possibly make enough money doing that.
Well, I thought you were a little smarter than that, Malcolm. It's not about money. It's about freedom. I am my own man. I do what I want, when I want. I don't answer to anyone for anything, ever.
Where's my 20 bucks, Leonard? You said you'd have it on Monday.
Yeah, I have it. It's right here. I was looking for you. You know, I couldn't find you, and then I had some important business meetings that I had to get to. But here, 13, 14, you take cigarettes, right?
I quit.
Oh, good for you. That's so good, because, you know, these things will kill you slow. That's the truth, you know, and the cost is the... Give him $6! Hey, take it easy, George. What a dumbass! You're really improving, Rubio. You stop making the vroom noises when you move your pieces.
Hey, Leonard.
Oh, you gotta see this. Physically hurts, doesn't it?
Listen, I was talking to this guy now. I got you a job interview.
What the hell are you talking about?
You are a miserable person. You barely have a job. And you're completely dysfunctional when it comes to communicating with people.
And that's my fault. It's not everyone else in the world.
It doesn't have to be like that. If you have a job where you're around people, you can get used to each other and maybe turn things around.
Forget it. I'm not wasting my time on some stupid job interview because you have some desperate need to save yourself through me.
Why don't you invest some of that neurotic energy in confronting your own fear of failure?
Oh, goodness. The clouds have parted, and I can now commit to a new life thanks to your Oprah-esque psychological insights.
And now you're trying to invalidate the real issue by dancing around it with what you think is clever wordplay. Screw this. I'll play you for it.
Why bother? We draw every game.
Not this time.
Fine, but if you don't win, you never bring this crap up again.
You're on.
Where's my money, Leonard?
Georgie, I got it. Just the other...
So how much?
Yes.
Dad, I just want to know. Do you have any kind of financial plan at all? Any plan about anything?
Malcolm, I'm telling you for the last time. Stop worrying about money.
Hey, I do your taxes. I know what you and Mom make. I know how much you're spending. I have a pretty good idea what it costs to have a baby. You guys are going to be at least $70 in the hole every month. By the time the baby starts school, you're going to be $18,000 in debt. And that's where they'll cut you off. You're going to be bankrupt and ruined.
Something will come up.
You can't keep saying that.
Fine. I'm a failure as a father. I'm a terrible provider. Is that what you want to hear?
No. But I have a way to fix it.
What's this?
It's from the Martindale Academy. It's this amazing prep school. But it's in London. They're offering me a complete scholarship. Tuition, housing, everything. If I'm not home, you just might make it. I'm totally willing to do it.
Absolutely not. You don't get to leave.
But
Malcolm, you're our only hope.
Hold this.
Sure. Let me explain something to you. Whenever your mother or I say something will come up or things will work out, that is our code for Malcolm will think of something. But we need you. The family is only a family as long as we all stick together. Where's Dewey?